Jeffrey, thank you very much for hosting our group here. You are the founder of IngDan, the largest IoT community, largest IoT platform in the world. Can you explain a little bit how it works, how you started, what the business model looks like?
IngDan is the largest IoT innovation platform in China. So we started this platform 3 years ago. Right now, there are already over 20,000 of the IoT companies joined this platform. Okay. Our core service is to link the global innovation companies with China-based manufacturing resources to convert their crazy ideas into the real products. So this is how we started this platform. And now we already build one of the largest ecosystem in the IoT space with the, tons of the startups and many other traditional companies join this platform. So right now we want to add more AI contents into this an IoT world. So that's since this year we call this platform is an AIoT platform.
Okay, and if you think about AI plus IoT, how do you see that work? What do you think are the benefits of that combination?
If without AI, so AI is embedded into the IoT. It's just like a machine with brain.
Yeah.
So if without AI, it's just a machine. But with AI, they will become an intelligent device, intelligent machine, use the cloud, use the big data as their brain. So that will completely change your lifestyle. For example, so if you walk into your home, your robot, based on your face, will know how happy you are or how bad you are, and then can give you the different music and give you a different, saying hard words. So that's things like that, simple things can, if you have the AI technology embedded, you will make your life easier and happier.
And if you look at China, is it already mainstream? Are many people already using AI plus IoT? Or is it still very niche at this moment?
I think it's AI plus IoT. It's just in the early stage, globally. But as you know, China actually is the one of the leading country. So starting to adoption of this AI technology into our daily life.
Yeah.
So that's we're going to see the AI technology plus embedded within IoT is going to completely change our lifestyle in the next couple of years.
Okay. There was this interesting question. Someone talked about Industry 4.0 that Germany is talking a lot about.
Mm.
What's your opinion about the Industry 4.0, and if you compare how China deals with that versus how countries like Germany deal with that, what's your view on that?
I think this, the first thing, that Industrial 4.0 is definitely one of the direction for the how to make the make this manufacturing industry more efficient, have the consumer demand, how to match the consumer demand. But on the other hand, I think what we're talking about, AI plus the automation, AI plus has application in different industry, is I think this concept is way beyond the 4.0, Industrial 4.0.
Okay.
So it's not just for the manufacturing itself. It's how to use the big data, use the AI technology to connect the consumer demand with each step of the manufacturing process.
Mm-hmm.
So in that case, so we believe in the future, we're going to see a lot of the new technology have been used on top of the Industrial 4.0.
Okay.
For example, we're going to see that blockchain technology, mm-hmm. we're going to see a lot of the AI technology or big data technology has been utilized to improve this manufacturing efficiency.
And if you look at China, what we see now here every day is China jumped from an analog world to a mobile world.
Yeah.
I think it's the most mobile country in the world today.
Yes.
Do you think the same can be done now if you look at manufacturing in China from a more traditional manufacturing process jumping immediately to one that is using AI, using smart automation, you think that jump could be made there as well?
Yes. You know, I think that's China today, I think is in a few, only a few countries in this planet, the government and the society will appreciate, you know, this manufacturing segment, and particularly, you know, using the technology to improve the manufacturing segment. So I think that's the very only a few places in this world to have that trend. So that we are going to see, you know, this AI and the industrial 4.0 technology has been widely adopted by the Chinese manufacturers, not only by those and the biggest guy in the market, but also by a lot of the SME vendors. So that's, I think that's from that point, I think that that's the Chinese the market, the uniqueness.
So you think the change will mainly come from the millions of SME companies that will completely jump to a new level of quality and speed.
Yes. So we're talking about in the automation industry. Yeah, so in the past, we're talking about how to use the people, jump into the user automation. Today, we're thinking about how to, you know, directly from the people, skip the automation to jump into the AI plus, you know, automation.
And in Europe, we look at the speed of change in China. It's fantastic to see that. Yeah. What is the secret? Why is China so fast, much faster than the US and a lot faster than Europe? How can you do that as a country, as a population?
I think that's, you know, because in China, so if you are not running a state-owned business, then that is supposed you are not in a non-monopoly market. So there are, you know, tons of the competition there. So no matter who you are, if you cannot move fast, make decision quicker, and execution wisely, you are losing the market very soon. Because, you know, in China there are so many smart people there waiting for you, making mistake and taking your market shares. So because of the Chinese domestic market is over competition, so that's the reason you have to act quicker and to survive. So sometimes we're talking about is more like the arm racing, but unfortunately it's the reality we have to face.
But it's an advantage because of that, the evolution that the country is going through is just very impressive.
I think that's a two-edged sword. So on the one hand, they're moving very quickly. On the other hand, so, you know, for many technology segment, you have to make a much longer investment to wait for the result to come. So do you have that kind of the patience to do that? So that's the, you know, what I'm not saying. So in certain industry, this way is a very, we would benefit from that. But on the other hand, for those, you know, some of the deep technology segment, you need the fundamental research and this kind of the stuff. So, and then, so you have to have the enough the patience and the resources to make investment for that.
And how do you deal with that in your company? Because IoT is still in its beginning. It will probably, you know, increase rapidly in the next 5 years, but 5 years is very long in China. So you need the patience and you need the speed, that combination. How do you personally deal with that as a leader in your organization?
So we have to control our, you know, how big, you know, how fast we could go. So we basically we are, I think the first thing, you cannot miss the direction. No matter who you are, if you miss the direction,
then it's,
you,
lost.
It's lost, you know. So what we believe the industry we are choosing is right. You know, there's the AI, IoT, automobile, machinery, etc. That's the right direction. Secondly, you have to have your own cash cow plus the innovation in the platform.
So you get money to fund your own innovation.
Yes. So that's the reason why, if you look at why our IngDan is able to be successful in past 3 years, because we patiently make investment without the, you know, to find the near-term return. But the reason why we are able to do that, because we have our own cash cow, which is a Cocoa Buy platform, which we sell our semiconductor and IC business. Yeah. So that's give you some of the sense. So if you look at any innovation company in China, like a Baidu, Alibaba, or Tencent, they have their own cash cow business on the one hand. Then they are able to use their other hands to try all kinds of the new business.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. And maybe last question, what is your ultimate dream with this company? When are you going to be totally happy?
Well, I in the very beginning, I want to have this IngDan platform. We're trying to try to democratize the IoT innovation. I believe, in the past, the Fortune 500 company, those big giants, the giants, they are able to access so many global resources by taking advantage of their size or their global network. But the internet is going to change that. So in that platform, we're positioning us like a sharing economy platform. So we want to use sharing economy concept to democratize the IoT innovation, make any youngster entrepreneur can access the same resources and information
all the barriers for
as those used to the previous Fortune 500 company can do it. So that's my dream.
That's beautiful. Well, thank you very much. I appreciated that we could come
thank
by
you.
And thanks for your time.
Thanks you very much. Thank
thanks
you. Very much.